Before I get into this, I want to say something about East German BDUs, fatigues, whatever you want to call them. These things are fetching collector's prices, and when I show them on here, I'm hoping people will seek these out when they're at secondhand stores, flea markets, yard sales, etc., etc., because I am in no way suggesting you need to drop $300 on a set of East German camo. I've just been really lucky at some of the stuff I found here and there, secondhand stores, etc., etc., and it's cultivated a very healthy interest in some of the behind-the-line survival tactics of the former Sneaky Bastards and the former DDR. Anyway, I'm going to show you what I got. Now, these trousers here came to me in a very unexpected way. They're actually Felsenjäger trousers, or reconnaissance trousers, or aerosol trousers, and they are purpose-built for Sneaky Bastards doing Sneaky Bastard shit. My intention wasn't really to seek these pants out, but I had bid on what I thought was a regular set, and then a dude changed the title of the listing on eBay, and by that point no one was really interested in them except for me with my bid, and I won them for like $40. And these are made differently than your normal BDUs, and as far as I know they kept the same design through the 60s, 70s, and 80s. They have a tapered bottom with draw cords, which is pretty handy. Both sides. A slight knee pad, which is actually a joke, but they made the knee pad out of the same feeling they use for the winter jacket, so it actually keeps my knees a little bit warmer. And I'm getting older and my knees are starting to let me know they're there, so that helps. The pockets here are actually more towards the front and the top, and that also helps me overall. And what I mean by that is these trousers, they're absolutely perfect for wearing as a base layer under my thermals in the winter time. The drawstring keeps them down, makes them more comfortable, traps the air in. They're baggy, and the pockets being up this high and towards the front, it's a lot easier to retrieve anything I got in my pocket that I need to get out. These trousers come specifically with a knife sheath, but I don't have the knife for it, and I never will because they're extremely expensive, and unless I find one at a flea market or something, it's just not going to happen. The fabric is the same thing that you would expect any kind of East German BDU to be made out of. The pockets on these are completely fabric. And that goes for the leg cargo pocket and the hip pocket. A lot of the East German stuff made later had a sort of gray mesh screen as pockets, as cost-cutting measure. And they are actually surprisingly strong, but that's another story. Now, this set of trousers here is the same one I spoke about in part two. I've done really nothing to them since part two, except I did get rid of the buttons and put elastic on the bottoms, and it actually helps them ride a whole lot better. I have the East German issue suspenders that's designed to work with these trousers. They're not looking so good. These things are probably over 30 years old. My sweat's starting to kill the leather. I expect them to snap any day now. I did order two other sets, and when they got here I stretched them and the elastic inside just turned to powder. I've also managed to get my hands on two BD blouses. These are the UTV version with four pockets, much like the US BDU from back in the day. One is an M56 in size and the other one is a K52. A K52 is a short, medium, large, and an M56 is a medium, extra large. One for winter use and one for summer use. There's nothing really special about these. They're just late issue four pocket blouses. I spoke about these in video number one, I believe. And I was fortunate enough to get both these blouses as a set with the trousers. So this is a medium large and an extra large set of trousers. They're the UTV version, which means they have the outside bellow pockets. Both these sets will get a reinforced ass, reinforced knees, and elastic in the bottom of the hem of the leg. Now, this is what I was talking about when I was referring to the gray mesh that they use as pockets. Now, these are kind of a unique item. These are bib overalls. And it's size K52. Plan for these is to make these work clothes because they're tough and they stow really well. And here is another set, and these are G56, which means the legs on them are really, really long. But fortunately, the East Germans had this thing about their jack boots. They love their jack boots, and they're hemmed really high, so they actually end up fitting me well. So the 52 is for summer, and the 56 is for winter. And these are actually the tops that go to the bib overalls, and they only have two breast pockets. Very simple design. They come down to about the top of my legs, and they have a macro rub holster. So that's two full sets of work clothing, and the elastic and the suspenders on these are nearly perfect condition. I think these were probably made in the early 90s. Here I have various splinter camo trousers from various time periods. If you look over them, you can start to see the cost-cutting measures they did to get by. This is the earliest set I have, and you can see it has a knee pad, and this one was pretty much the same era, does not. The gray pebble buttons usually donate something that's really old, probably from the 60s, and then the 70s, they started getting a little bit weirder, a little bit cheaper. Here's the gray mesh, and the older version is a cotton pocket. This piece of trim right here is cotton, but on this one it's a gray mesh, indication that they were sucking for money. Anyway, I'm not going to nerd out. I'm just trying to give a little bit of detail. So overall, I have enough of these trousers, and the shirts that actually match these trousers laying in front of me. Some of them can be laid to the shears and sacrificed for sewing projects like reinforcing knees and ass, and some will go inside the survival pods. And there's three shirts from various time periods, all the same pattern, of course. Some have the pebble buttons. Some have the hidden buttons under the flaps. Some have tiny foliage loops. Others do not. Nothing special here. Same deal. Some will get sacrificed and laid to the shears. And I'll keep a couple. And last but not least, I ended up with 5 Zeltbonds when all was said and done. And I think like 3 of these I got off of eBay just by simply typing in old army tarp, and people had them, didn't know what they were, and I got them for like 15, 20 bucks. These vary in age. This is probably my oldest one. I was told the light tan was an indication of an earlier one, but I don't know, because that one here is the same color as all my other ones, which I think are younger. One indication is they were using cotton rope, and as they got poorer and poorer, they started using crappy ass nylon rope. I mean, it works. All of these work. Out of all the Zeltbonds I use, Austrian and East German are probably the best. The only reason I mention the age is because, well, I'm a bit of a nerd, and sometimes I use age as a way to gauge whether or not something's gonna work properly for me. But it's not an exact science. Anyway, that concludes number 3 of the videos, and I will not be doing a number 4. I'm tired of talking about this crap, but it's been sitting around and I wanted to get it done. Thanks for watching.
Du hast viel geweint, im Geist getrennt, im Herzen.